Imagine a school full of students eager to learn. I want to give you an inside view of my world, the world of vocational education. And about half of the Dutch youth follows vocational education. So you will meet my students, my former students, all the day. I mean, your heating engineer is a former student of mine, and your store staff is a former student, maybe your hairdresser or the teacher, the dance instructor of your kids is a former student. And we teach them, we prepare them for a job, and we teach them coping strategies for society. And earlier this year, I saw a movie, a documentary-style movie. It's called Chimpanzee. And it's about a group of chimps, with one chimp in it, a little Oscar. He's 1 year old, and he lost his mother. But he was taught all kinds of skills by an alpha male. That's little Oscar. And the alpha male taught him, for example, how to crack nuts. So Oscar survived. And the attention of my profession could not be explained better than by that movie. Because we still have students, and we still have a teacher, and we teach them all kinds of things to survive. In a million years, the attention of my profession did not change. And it strikes to me that not only the intention did not change in a million of years, but also the methods of transferring knowledge did not change. I mean, you still have a teacher. And you still have students who sees what the teacher does, who copies it, and who practice it. Just like little Oscar and the alpha male. And the teacher is so essential for vocational education. You can say, well, you can tell the students to sit in front of the computer all day. You can say, follow the lectures at home. You can use the newest technology in your lessons. But they don't want to sit in front of the computer all day. They want a teacher, a role model, who stimulates them, who motivates them. That's important. And they want to learn with each other, in a group, just like little Oscar. So, when I think for education is not always, cannot always be fun. When I think of my students, my adolescents, they're not grown up yet. They have to, sometimes they have to do things they don't want to learn. 2 pages of text reading. I said, you have to read these 2 pages of text. They say, well, I can't read that long. I can't concentrate that long. It's difficult for me. I said, you have to read that. And sometimes they must listen to a story for 30 minutes. And then they say, well, I can't do that without comments. I said, you have to listen. And the learning success is the rewarding feeling they get when they think, hey, they experience, I can read. And I can't listen to that story for 30 minutes. So the teacher bonds with them, stimulates them, and motivates them. And of course, adolescents change jobs very often, and the profession is changing, the contents of the profession is changing. So it's not about what we learn them, but it's more about their learning attitude. We must teach them a learning attitude, an active learning attitude, and an entrepreneurial attitude, a flexible attitude. And last year I was in Cambridge, and I met a Nigerian colleague. And he said, oh, I want to do a job exchange with you. I said, oh, nice. And he told me, we exchanged information. And our jobs, he in Africa, my job here in Ede, seems to be equal. Both students, both teacher, both classrooms, both students who are eager to learn because they want to get a diploma. And he said, well, you found my closet in my classroom, and They have binders, shelves with binders. There are two binders. You will find a binder with the title exams, and you will find a binder with the title learning materials. I said, okay. I have a closet too in my classroom. But there are not two binders in it. No, 30 binders. 30, he said, yes. I said, well, we created a whole world of systems around the actual teaching. I said, one of my titles is protocol examination, protocol open day, protocol inspection visit, minutes of team meetings, minutes of department minutes, realized hours, planned hours, all kind of titles. Oh, well, he said, after my explanation of my job, he said, I don't want to do that job exchange anymore. Okay. He said, yeah, I want to focus on real of actual teaching. Okay. Well, that was the end of my African adventure. It didn't even start it yet, unfortunately. And I want to conclude my talk with a recap. First of all, I would emphasize that the vocational education needs a teacher. A teacher who can bounce with the adolescents. Because the adolescent is not an adult yet. That's the most important thing. And second of all, I want to emphasize the fact that we have to focus less on the world of system we create around actual teaching and focus more on the real thing, the real teaching. Okay. Thank you for your attention.